Good morning and welcome to another online assembly. By now you should at the very least know what the Quaker testimonies are. They are of course simplicity, peace, integrity, community, equality and sustainability. And today it's the turn of equality, something that's been in the news recently. For reasons which have become clear, some Quakers prefer to think of this as part of the last testimony we talked about, community, with each person valued for their unique contribution to the whole. Quakers regard each individual as being of equal worth, and although they're not alone in that, it's something that's a characteristic of how they live. It helps shape the ethos of our school and nurtures the strong sense of pastoral care that's so important to everyone here at Friends. Treating everyone as equal doesn't mean that they're all the same, far from it. We're all different with different talents and different personalities, and we all end up in different places. We want to celebrate that diversity. However, we want to do what we can to give everybody the opportunities they need to flourish in their own lives, both here in school and elsewhere. Early Quakers objected to the hierarchy that they saw in the church at the time and to the privilege of the clergy over the people. This was reflected in their style of worship and also echoes what the New Testament writer James has to say about favouritism. Suppose a man comes into your meeting wearing a gold ring and fine clothes, and a poor man in filthy old clothes also comes in. If you show special attention to the man wearing fine clothes and say, "Here's a good seat for you," but say to the poor man, "You stand there or sit on the floor by my feet," have you not discriminated amongst yourselves and become judges with evil thoughts? So right from the start, this was a mark of distinction for the Quakers. They also refused to use titles which reflected social distinctions when referring to others by name, as they thought that this introduced a form of inequality into everyday speech. Even today, it's common for Quakers to use people's full names when addressing them, rather than using Mr. and Mrs., for example. Quakers did not shy away from social issues either. Quakers have long fought for equality, and were one of the first groups to speak out against slavery, for example. I don't need to tell you that that's something that's been brought into sharp focus recently, following the death of George Floyd in Minneapolis at the hands of the US police. One of the few things during the last 10 weeks that has got greater prominence on the news than the coronavirus. It was a reminder not only of the inequality that exists today, but also of the legacy of historical inequality. And it serves as a rebuke to us all that such a thing can happen in what we regard as a civilized society. We shudder rightly at the thought that people can be treated in this way because of the color of their skin, and I hope that it will help motivate us to try to eradicate inequality and discrimination where we see it in our own lives and in our own society. The current crisis also threatens to create inequalities because of the closure of schools and the threat to businesses, which puts many people's livelihoods at risk and denies people opportunities they might otherwise have had. People have been finding things difficult in all sorts of ways, struggling financially or with mental health, and it's been heartening to see the efforts of others, including you, to provide support to people in these situations. But this will need to continue once this has passed, if we're to avoid even greater division in our society in the future. Of course, even if most people agree that it's a good idea, achieving equality is notoriously difficult. In George Orwell's Animal Farm, the animals overthrow the humans who've been mistreating them and establish a farm where each animal has an equal share in everything. But it's not long before the pigs start to benefit more than others, and you'll be familiar with the phrase, "some animals are more equal than others." In this case, it's not the fact that the pigs gain power that is the problem or that creates inequality. It's how they exercise that power and use it to subjugate others. As I said at the beginning, it's more about how we value each individual and treat each person with dignity and respect. Only then can we claim to prioritise equality and avoid the kind of situation that arose with George Floyd. We might consider how our behaviour either reduces inequality or increases the likelihood of it. Before you buy something, do you consider its origins? Do we treat people with greater respect if they're wealthy or popular? Or do we look for and cherish the individual talents of those around us? Do we recognise people for who they are? Do we treat people as we ourselves would like to be treated, with dignity and respect? Because it all comes down to that. We should value ourselves and give equal value to others. Here's another side to the equality coin. Venerating other people or putting them on a pedestal is not helpful either, as we can forget they have flaws just like everyone else. But perhaps that's a subject for another day. I referred to community earlier, and here's the link. Only if we value others, their individual talents, and their unique contribution do we have any hope of building a flourishing community, either here in our school or in our society. Well, thank you very much for joining us again for today's assembly. I hope you have a good week. We've got about 2 weeks left of term now, so I'd encourage everyone to persevere with their studies for the next 2 weeks and to make sure as much progress has been made as possible before the end of term. You'll have a good break after that, and I hope that with the current easing of lockdown restrictions, you'll be able to enjoy the summer holidays. You'll probably have heard a lot of things about return to school in the autumn term. I think it's fair to say at the moment we just don't know what's going to happen, but we will be in touch with you and your parents over the next couple of weeks to let you know as much as we know, and please be assured that we're doing everything we can to try to prepare for a start to the new term. We think it's really important that you're in school. We hope to be able to provide an education here at Friends for you in the autumn term. We just have to wait to see what the restrictions are, what the safety advice is, and how we can manage to make a safe return to school. So we look forward to that time. We'll give you more information in the weeks ahead. And in the meantime, I hope everyone has a good week.